Hello guys, my name is Ramji Mishra. I am from Dr. D.Y. Patel Institute of Technology at ENTC department. I am having Abhijit Shinde, assistant professor, and my classmate Priyama Munkar.
Today we are going to see practical of sampling theorem and aliasing effect. As you know, sampling theorem states that if a finite energy signal having frequency components higher than omega hertz, then it can be recovered from its samples, which are at 1 by 2 omega seconds apart. An aliasing effect is defined as when two adjacent spectrums overlap, then aliasing effect occurs.
Thank you, Ramji and Priya. Let's see the flow of our program. First, we are going to define signal parameters. Then we are going to plot this continuous time signal. We know that in sampling, we are having three conditions. One is a sampling signal equal to twice of the frequency of our signal. Second, where the sampling frequency is greater than twice of that of our signal frequency. Third, where a sampling frequency is lesser than twice of our signal frequency. So first, we will sample a signal with fs is equal to our signal frequency. Once we did that, we are going to plot that. As this is sampled, the signal will be converted into discrete time. So we are going to plot this dt signal. Once we did that, we are going for second condition where sampling will be greater than twice of that of our signal. Let's consider that we will sample it with 6 times that of frequency. Okay, so fs will be 6 times that of our signal frequency. Again, we are going to plot this dt signal. Third case, we are going to sample that with less than that of the twice of. So we will sample it. Consider that with fs is equal to 1.6 times that of our plot this dt signal, and we will stop. This is the general flow of our practical. First, we will consider that the time period of our signal as 4. So the frequency of signal will be 1 upon t. We need to consider this ct, continuous time signal, is continuous in the frequency, in the time. We need to see, we need to analyze a signal in particular time frame. Let's consider that we are considering this signal, say t is equal to minus 10. In this time period, we are going to consider a signal. And we know the standard formation of our signal is a cos 2 pi f into, in this f is taken from this and t is taken from. Let's see how the MATLAB program for this is going to work. So the first three lines are obvious. We are clearing all the workspace. We are closing all the windows and we are clearing the command window. After that, we need to define t, that is time period of our signal, as 4. The frequency is equal to capital F, frequency is equal to 1 upon t. Then we need to define small t, which is the time period in which we are going to analyze a signal, as say minus 10, the interval of say 0.01 to 10. And I will write x1 as cos of 2 into I into f into, I'm going to plot this against t, and let's see if I'll plot it, what I'll get. Okay, so this signal we had where a sine wave has been plotted. Now we are going to sample this signal with fs is equal to twice of the frequency of a signal. Now consider that this is our signal. If I'm saying the sampling frequency is twice of the frequency of this signal, does it means that in one cycle of a signal I am going to take, let's say at this point and at this, so at every cycle I'm going to take samples. In this figure, is from this point to this point, it completes one cycle. So in this whole cycle, I'm going to take 2 points. Let's calculate how many points will be there in entire range of this time. First sample will be at this point, second will be at this point, third will be at this point, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 and 11. This is 0, So this is the start of our sample. On the left side, that is on the negative side, we are having 5 samples. On right side, we are having 5 samples. So if I am sampling this signal, say F1, which is the sampling frequency, that will be twice of my F. I will have total minus 5 in the range of 1 to 5 samples. So let's consider this as N1. And suppose if I am defining this as X1, this X1 will be cos of 2 into pi into, okay. So this F is sampled at this. So in DT sample, we write this as capital F divided by F1 into N1. So this is our new signal which we have sampled. Now we are not going to plot it. Plot gives the continuous plotting. So we are going to use stem over here. Stem N1 comma X. So this is going to give us a plot. Okay, there will be error at this point. So it is 2 into F. We are supposed to write 2 into F. So let's run it. So this signal we got. So we got total 11 samples, and at every cycle we got 2 samples. But what happened over here is that the previous plot has been erased. This new plot has been overprinted on previous plot. So what we are going to do is that we are going to use subplot. Subplot 221, and here I will use subplot 222. And if I'll run this, let's see what happens. Single window, we can have two signals side by side. This is our original sine wave, and this is the sampled signal. Here, this point, there is one sample. At this point, there is another sample, and so on. So this is the output where we got a sample of sampling this of that of our signal frequency. Sample this signal sampling frequency greater than that of our signal frequency. Let's consider that it is 6 times that of F. When we sample for a signal with twice of that of our signal frequency, get 5 samples. On left side, 5 samples. The right side and one at the 0. If I sample this at 6 times, how many samples I will get on left side? That is x is equal to 15. So on left side I will get 15, on right side I will get 15. That means our N2 will run from minus 15 to 15 in the interval of 1. Okay, let's write that. So N2 is equal to minus 15, the interval of 1 to 15. X2 will be cos of, and this will be F2. Now F2 is F2, and I have to use subplot. This is 223. Let's plot this. Let's write stem. Okay, so if I'll run this, we got a good sampled signal. Now here we are not understanding, okay, what will be the recovered signal in both of this. So for that purpose, what we can have, we can connect this dot and find out what will be the recovered signal. How we can do that? We will hold this and we will plot signal for that. Here also we will do the same thing. We will hold this and plot N2. If we'll run this, this red line shows a recovered signal. Here you can see that if the sampling frequency is high, the recovered signal will be as close as that of our original signal. If we sample the signal with exactly that of the twice of the signal frequency, the signal will be somewhat triangular. We are going to sample our signal with a sampling frequency lesser than that of our twice of our signal frequency. Now suppose I am sampling our signal with 1.6. Okay, so at that time how many samples I am going to get on the left side? 4. So N3 will run from minus 4 in the interval of 1, and F3 will be 1.6 times that of our signal frequency. Let's write the code for that. So it will run from minus 4 to 4. This is N3, this is F3 is 1.6, subplot 224, okay, this is X3, this is F3, this is N3, I will plot X3 against N3, okay, let's run this. This is the last plot. You can see that we had how many cycles in our original signal? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And if I'm sampling our signal with exactly twice of that our signal frequency, then we are actually getting 5 cycles. If I'll sample that more than that of our twice of that our signal frequency, again we are going to get 5 cycles. But if we'll sample our signal with less than that of twice that of our signal frequency, we are going to get less cycles. That means the frequency of this signal, recovered signal, is lesser than that of our original signal, and this is called as aliasing effect. Now you can give the label to x-axis, y-axis, and each of the plot a title you can give, and you can have the good plot. This is the first practical of sampling theorem. Thank you.